Hello guys, my name is Hartvinder. Today we are going to learn ICT's second chapter of IGCSE, that is input and output devices. Let us start. Input devices means when we are entering something in our computer, that means something input our computer is getting from the user, that is the input, that through devices through which we give the input to the computer are called the input devices, like keyboard, mouse, barcode reader, optical character recognition, MICR, your microphone, right now I'm using a microphone to input my voice into a computer. These all devices are called the input devices. The output devices through which we a user get the output from a computer, like a monitor, printer, speakers. The devices which give the output to the user, those are called the output devices. Let us read some input and output devices. Let us start with the input keyboard. Keyboard, as you know, is a very common device, very common general purpose input device that allows text ABC, numbers 1, 2, 3 and symbols like percent sign, that dollar, at the rate, so many to be entered into a computer. Numeric keypad, this is a small keyboard just to enter numerical data. These are mostly used on for the calculating purpose in the shopping malls, on the place where we give the bill. There we use maximum normally this type of keyboards, where we mostly use the numbers instead of other alphabetics. PIN card reader, mostly you know, if you are using a credit card or a debit card, this is a device that a numeric keypad used to enter person's personal identity numbers, PIN. For example, when paying with a credit card or with a debit card, for example, you have shopped and you want to pay a bill through a debit card or credit card, you use this device, that is a PIN pad, where we insert the card and it asks for your personal identification number, PIN. Then you enter the PIN, then it accepts that value and they deduct, they fill the amount of how much they want to receive from the user, or the that after accepting this, they deduct the money from your bank. This is a card we use to access our personal bank account through your debit or credit card. This device is used for a personal identity number. Next, some input pointing devices. Let us discuss some input pointing devices. Like these devices are used to move an on-screen pointing pointers or cursors, usually an arrow. They are commonly used with the graphical user interface, GUIs. GUIs means where we can just click instead of writing a command. In the previous days, we were using a command line interface, CLI, command line interface, where we need to write any command. If you want to execute a command, you need to write, you need to type. But nowadays we are using a graphical user interface, which is a GUIs. Here we use mouse, touch screen, touchpad, light pen, stylus. These devices are used in GUIs for pointing. Instead of writing a command manually, we use the pointing devices. Mouse. A mouse, a pointing device found on most PCs, sensors on the bottom of the mouse detects when the mouse is moved. This mouse device you mostly use, we use in our computers, desktop PCs and laptops. We can externally attach the mouse. Mostly laptops having a touchpad, but we can externally attach the mouse with that if we want to use them more comfortably. So this is a pointing device. There is a sensor at the bottom of the mouse which senses the movement and the of the cursor. Touchpad, trackbar, these are used in laptops mostly, where we don't need to attach external mouse. The pointing device found on most laptops used instead of mouse, since it takes up less space. It takes very less space as compared to other mouse. Trackball, tracker ball. These pointing devices is not moved about like a mouse. Instead, it has a large ball that the user finds, used by the people with a limited movement, disabled, very young. Very young means that small children. Children, they can't hold the mouse properly. Means if the child is of 2-3 years old, they can use a trackball easily. Most disabled persons can also use a trackball instead of mouse. This is. Then touch screen, you know very well now all smartphones, every smartphone is having a touch screen. Some shopping malls, in hospitals, anywhere we can see the touch screen. Even in ATMs, if you want to withdraw money, you use your ATM, there you use a touch screen instead of buttons. So with the touch screen, the user selects the items on a screen by touching the surface. Because they are so intuitive to use, and how they are getting cheaper to manufacture, touch screens will probably become the most common hardware interface for our electronic gadgets. It is a most common, mostly we are, this is our electronic gadget we are using. Graphic tablets, the pointing device often used by the designers and artists to allow natural hand movement to our input to graphic applications. Suppose you are a good artist, you are drawing, your handmade drawing is very good. There you want to use a drawing with a digital drawing, you want to use instead of just in ordinary way on drawing on a paper. We can use this graphic tablet, freehand drawing you can do here. As you are watching in the picture, so in this way that can be a digital drawing, and an artist can show his talent through this graphic tablet. It will save our paper also, and more options will be available here. If you are drawing in an ordinary way, you need a lot of things like the brush, different colors, and with all these things you can't make such a wonderful drawing which a graphic, through graphic tablets you can make. And nowadays mostly we need digital drawings, your handmade drawings and artist talents digitally, because if you want to show your drawing on a social media and on any website, we need the digital pictures. It's not required every time we need a hard copy to hang on the walls. So this graphic tablet is a very very useful for the artist people. They can use it to show and their talent, and they directly can take the digital drawing. In other way, you will draw a drawing on a paper in ordinary way, after that you will click the photo, a high quality photo, then you will upload on the social media websites or somewhere. But in this way it will directly be a digital drawing, and you can say this 3D drawings also can be made. So a wonderful device. Let us move further. Joystick, joypad used mainly playing games, you know very well, for playing games we can use these devices. Light pen is a device used for as a pointing device or write on the screen of a computer. Similarly, as we have discussed, for drawing we use graphical tablets. If you want to write with your handwriting in a digital way, we can use this light pen, digital signatures, etc. Scanner, a scanner that scans image, book, pages, etc. That is a scanner we use mostly. Digital camera, device that captures digital photographs. The camera's computer runs a very simple operating system stored on a ROM and usually provides a menu-based GUI for the user. Nowadays, you can use these type of cameras, digital cameras, and the side by side you can view also similarly how you captured the movie, and even in the real time you can watch the expressions which you have captured, the shoots which you have captured in the real time you can review them. Video cameras are the device that captures moving images or videos, moving images for and real time videos capturing. Webcam, if you want to talk a face to face video conferencing, suppose you are in India and your relative is in Canada, you want to do a real time conversation by face to face conversation, we can use webcams, you know very well. Microphones, right now I am using a microphone for inputting my voice into a computer. And if through a desktop computer or laptop you want to use a verbal and a visual conversation, we can use this microphone. This is inbuilt in smartphones. An input device that converts sound into a signals that can be fed into a computer. Analog, the voice which we are speaking, that is in an analog form. To digital converter, ADC is used for this, usually built into a camera sound card. This converts the analog voice to a digital converter, ADC. Input card readers, these are the input card readers for reading different cards. We can use these devices. Magnetic stripe reader. Usually the data stored on a stripe in the same data shown on the front of the card, for example a credit card number, expiry date and customer name. A magnetic stripe reader is used to read the data from the stripe. I'll give you an example. Suppose you want to pay your bill through your debit card online. You need your debit card number and then CVV. Sometimes they ask for the name of the card holder. But if you swap your card in a magnetic stripe, then it doesn't ask anything about this, because all these things are fed in this stripe. You just need to swap that card and it will automatically read. So this is a magnetic stripe reader which reads the information of related to account of our users. It doesn't, you don't need to manually feed the information. If you are just swiping. Next is a smart card chip reader. Nowadays the ATM cards, so you can say debit or credit cards, have both options, stripe and a magnetic chip reader. Both data can be stored in a memory and read back using a chip reader. Chip reader also can store the information. You can this reader, that can be a Wi-Fi chip also, which can read the information from a distant. This chip reader doesn't ask for the pin sometime also. Then input reading test codes. Now we will learn about some input test codes, how we can read the test codes. Input reading test codes. All data could be input to a computer using a keyboard, but this would often be a slow process and mistakes would be made. Sometimes speed and accuracy is required. For these purpose, we need these input test reader codes. MICR reader, magnetic ink character recognition. MICR is a technology that allows details from bank check to be read from the computer quickly and accurately. Suppose you are entering the this check number manually through a keyboard, it may be a wrong and sometimes it is a slow process also. It's difficult for the user, that person who is operating a bank person, a bank manager. But if you are using this machine, MICR reader, it will directly read that check characters, the characters on a check, magnetic character reader. You don't need to, that user or bank manager doesn't need to enter the manually through a keyboard. This machine, MICR, can read it quickly and accurately. Now OMR scanner, optical mark recognition. OMR is a technology that allows the data from the multiple choice type form to be read quickly and accurately into a computer. You must be knowing about this OCR, OMR sheet. OMR means for solving multiple choice questions. Normally we see in competitive exams, we use this sheet. for checking, for evaluating this sheet, if you if the evaluator will do the manually, it may be time consuming, and mostly it can be a mistakes in these, because human being can do the mistakes. Through this machine, OMR, optical mark recognition, the process of reading this sheet will be a fast and accurate results we can get from this, because before just inserting this sheet into a machine, we will set the answers for first answer, which option is correct, for the second answer, which option is correct. Then we will insert this sheet into a machine, and that will match accordingly. If the first option matches with the first option which the that candidate has attempted is matching, then it will mark it as a correct answer, otherwise it will mark as a wrong answer. So the first time we have to program the things, we will have to program the answers, and we can mark thousands, millions of sheets through that. If you are doing a manually, every time you, a person need to check the answer manually, the accuracy and time consuming process is that the accuracy will not be optimum if manually a human being is checking these OMR sheets. So this machine, optical mark recognition technology, is a wonderful process for for checking, evaluating the OMR sheets. Now OCR, optical correct recognition, is a software technology that can convert images of text into actual text file that can then be edited. Suppose you have some material in notebook, in a book, you want to type that. You will type through a keyboard, but there is a machine, OCR scanner, which will read that book characters, that image, the image of that page, that will convert into a characters. So you can edit those characters also. The printed page can be read through this machine, and that image will be read, and after that will be converted into characters. If you are taking a picture of that page through a camera, it will not be editable. That OCR makes you to make that image editable. Barcode reader simply a numeric code represented as a series of lines for reading the price or that information of particular product. In shopping malls, you normally see these barcode readers in your notebook, in your books, also in the back last page, you can see these barcodes in any product in your home or somewhere. You can see normally these barcodes. For reading these barcodes, for getting the information through these barcodes, this barcode reader scanner is used. Input sensors. Now we'll talk about the sensors. Without contacting with the device physically, we can use the sensors. For example, I'll give you, suppose you are going in a shopping mall. Sometimes you see you don't need to open the door physically. When you go near the door, it will opens automatically. How it happens? Because of sensors. Sometimes you don't need to increase or decrease the cooling of your ACs, air conditions. It automatically does because of sensors. Through the sensors, it senses how much cooling according to the environment, according to the climate. It senses how much cooling is required in this room. So these are the sensors are very, very, very useful. For if you are going to a bank for withdrawing money or accessing your account, they ask you just finger impressions. So these finger impressions, these are the biometric sensors you can use. So let us learn about the sensors. Input sensors. The sensors is a device that converts the real world properties, for example temperature, into data that capture computer can process. Different sensors having different detections. temperature detects the temperature, light detects the light, dark, moisture, dampness and dryness, water level, how full empty a container is, movement nearby, proximity, how close, far something is, switch or button, if something is touching, pressing it. Input sensors, the sensors measures the specific property data and sends the signals to a computer. Analog signals convert into a digital, analog to digital converter ADC. Sensors are used extensively. These just gets the input from the real world and converts it into a digital and give to the computer. This as picture shows a device, input sensor device converts real world property. Temperature, sound, body movements, analog data. This picture shows. Let us input remote control. This is also sensor. They send data signals each time a button is pressed using an infrared light or radio signals. The signals that control the computer from some distance. Now let us talk about the output audio and visual. Now we have learned about the input devices. Now we will learn about the output devices. Output devices like monitor, printer, through which we get the information. So firstly, the CRT monitor. Earlier old days, we were using these CRT monitors. These were very excellent quality. Now we are using LCDs. They are not giving sometimes not giving us much clear pictures and color combination. But these CRT monitors were giving a real pictures and colors in very good quality. But nowadays these are obsoleted by the OLEDs and LCDs. The cathode CRT stands for cathode ray tube monitors, is a type that has been around for years and large and boxy. The color accuracy and brightness of CRT monitors is excellent and designers need to see true to life colors. Nowadays when we are using LCDs, OLEDs, but still we can see in some shops, the photographers shops, we can see these CRT monitors. Still they are using CRT monitors because they rely more on CRT monitors as compared to modern technology, LCDs and OLEDs. Flat screen monitors, TFT or LCDs, these days mostly we use these type of monitors. TFT and LCDs are two of the technologies used in flat screen monitors. TFT is thin film transistor. TFT stands for thin film transistors, and LCD is liquid crystal display. Another technology that may replace these are OLEDs or organic light emitting diodes. OLEDs, the further technology. Now digital multimedia projector in your classroom, you can see these digital multimedia projectors. If you want to show the monitor screen on a large size on a wall, the audience, the large number of audience is sitting in the classroom, they can't view all view on a monitor in a small screen. Even if you place a LCD on a wall, that will not be a visible, much visible. There we need this projector, you know, used in a situation when a very large viewing area is required. A projector connects to a computer, a DVD player or a satellite receiver just like an ordinary monitor. The image is produced inside the device and then projected out through the large lens using a powerful light source. Loudspeakers, if you want to hear music or sound from your computer, you will have to attach loudspeaker. They convert electrical signals into a sound waves. Output printing plottings, for getting information on a hard copy, we need these printing and plottings. Mostly I recommend that take the printout if it is required, because save paper, save environment. But sometimes we need the information on a hard copy to display on our walls or somewhere, just to for the advertisement purpose. On the roads we need to display, we need have these type of hard copies. But now hard copies are mostly replaced by the digital copies on the roads. Also in the developed countries we can see the digital screens for the advertisement purposes. If you want a physical copy of some data on a paper, a hard copy, you will need a device that can make mark on a paper, a printer or a plotter. So let us learn about the different printers like dot matrix, laser and this inkjet printer, then we will learn about the plotters. What are the difference between the plotter and printer, that will also we will learn. A dot matrix printer is a old, mostly the dot matrix printer is named after the pattern, a grid or matrix of dots used when creating the paper printout. These dots are formed by tiny pins in the printer's print head that hit the inked linked ribbon against the paper, leaving marks dots. These type of printers are mostly used when we need slips in railway stations for taking a printout of railway ticket. These type of printers are used. These dot matrix printers. Dot matrix printer often use continuous stationery, long continuous stripe. This you can see in the picture, long continuous stripe of paper rather than separate sheets of A4 like we use in inkjet laser printouts. It need a long continuous stripe of paper. Dot matrix printer's quality is very poor. The printer are noisy. Since the pins actually hit the paper, several carbon copies can be printed in a one go. We can take a number of carbon copies by putting a carbon paper inside, and in the middle of two papers we can take through a dot matrix printer. It physically contacts with the paper. The printer mechanism is very cheap and linked ribbon lasts for a long time. It's a very, very, very much cheapest way of taking a printouts. Inkjet printers. Earlier we have learned about the dot matrix printer. Now we will learn about the inkjet printer. Cheap, high quality, full colored printing became available during the 1990s. Due to the development of inkjet printers, the square tiny drops of the ink onto a surface of a paper, the droplets of ink come from tiny holes, the jets. The perfect photographs, very quiet in use, cheap to purchase and manufacture. Ink is very expensive to buy. These are expensive. Ink is expensive to buy. The printers, if you go in the market and for buying a printer, it will be a cheaper for you. But when you start using it, then you will come to know this is a expensive when you will go for buying a ink, because it consumes a lot of ink for taking a printouts. In the previous dot matrix printer, we are not using an ink, we are using a ribbon that can last for a long time. But this here we use liquid ink, which consumes more as compared to ribbon, and it's expensive. For buying a printer in the market is cheaper. When we are using taking a printout per sheet, it costs more as compared to laser printer and dot matrix printer, but it gives a very high quality pictures. How it works? This close up the tiny ink dots on a page. The dots combine to form a light and dark areas. These are the, in the picture you can see the printer and the liquid bottles of inks. The four type of four colored ink bottles are used in this black, this and why. These picture qualities you can see through dots we take the printout. Now laser printers, mostly we use laser printers in offices, in your schools you can see these laser printers. If you will go in the market to buy a printer, it will be a costlier as compared to inkjet printer. But when you will take the printout per sheet, cost will be a very, very much less as compared to inkjet printer, because here we are not using liquid in place of this. Instead of liquid ink, here we will use dry ink, and you can refill that in a very low cost. It per sheet cost will be a very less as compared to inkjet printer, but for buying, for one time buying of a printer will be a much costly as compared to inkjet printer. But the image quality as compared to inkjet printer will not be a good in case of laser printer. Inkjet printer is the best for image quality, but it will be a costlier per sheet costlier. Laser printer and dot matrix printers are costlier when you are buying a printer, but per sheet cost is very less as compared to inkjet printers. But image quality in both these printers, laser printer and inkjet printer, in dot matrix printer, is poor as compared to inkjet printers. Inkjet printer is the best for the image quality. For taking a lot of pages, say suppose you want to print a full book or thousands of question papers in a school, then this laser printer is the best, because if you will use their inkjet printer or dot matrix printer, it will take a lot of time to print a page and will be a costlier. The inkjet printer will be a much costlier as compared to this laser printer. A very complex device, expensive to buy. Expensive if you are going to buy a printer, it will be a costlier. But when you are using, per sheet cost will be a very less, very cheap to use. A single toner cartridge will often last for a 5,000 to 10,000 pages for a printing. Means 5,000 to 10,000 printing pages can be printed with a single toner. Very fast printing. In case of inkjet printer, you can take maximum 150 pages with a single pack of bottles. But here you can take 5,000 to 10,000 pages with a single toner, and you can, after that you can easily refill a dry ink at a very low cost. Now, how laser printer work? The printer laser beams your print onto a metal cylinder called a drum. Using a static electricity, the drum attracts powdered toner from a cartridge to the drum. The drum rolls the toner onto a paper into a form of your print. The toner is melted onto the paper by heat from the fuser as it possesses underneath. Your print comes out of the printer. So here we can see the picture of the how the laser printer works. Laser scanning unit, mirror, toner coated roller, charging electrode, and this photo receptor drum. Now plotter for taking a big banners advertisement purpose, or a long stripe, we can use the plotter. For example, there is a fair in your school, you want to take the printout of slips, tickets which you will give to the audience for entry pass. A long stripe you need to print. Here you can use the plotter. Here laser printer, inkjet printer, dot matrix printer will not be a suitable. Here plotter can be used. Draw on a paper using a pen more accurately and more quickly. Plotter are only suited for producing a line drawing. Plotters have been largely superseded by the large formal inkjet printers that can produce more detailed printout and in full color. Now output control actuators. Let us learn about sensing elements, then command elements, then output elements. These are the different control actuators. Output control actuators. Actuators is a device controlled by the computer that can affect the real world. Actuator, light bulb or LED, creates light. Cooling unit, decrease temperatures. Motor, spinning using a round pumps, pushes water air through a pipes. Buzzer, bell, siren, creates noise. So this motor can provide movements for this moving a disc. We use this motor, and pumps is basically a motor attached to a device that can push water or air long pipes. For example, the buzzer in a microwave oven can be switched on by controlling computer when food is cooked. Or one more example, suppose a water tank is filled up to brim, then we can just attach our device buzzer that sense will sense the level of water and will siren and give the indication that that water tank has been filled up to the brim. So we can switch off that water pump. You can save the water as well as electricity. This gives you an indication that we can save using this device, this buzzer. Now lights, light bulbs and LEDs can be used to provide the light for the indication, indicate something. Suppose you are driving a car on a road, and in front of you another person is driving and he suddenly brakes, then a brake light will just blink. It shows, it says the person has braked down his car, and you can stop also your car for it can big accident can be saved through these indicators. You want to turn, you can give the indication to indication of a turn, parking indications. So these are the light indicators we can use. Then heater and coolers, heaters can provide heat and coolers can cool the things down. You are using your computer, it will heat up for cooling down. You use the coolers as can be used. So this is what our chapter of input and output device. Hope you have enjoyed it. Thank you very much. See you again. Thank you very much.